Hello everyone, we are back going to do a full kit build of the 125th scale 1932 Ford Phantom Vicky from AMT. It is in the Hot Wheels theme. They've got the Hot Wheels license and they are putting those decals on everything. Otherwise, it's going to be the same cool 1932 Ford Phantom Vicky with the 4.6 liter Cobra engine that you've all come to love and know. It's got a very 90s feel to it because of the wheels and tire and that engine under the hood. So we're going to take a look. Now remember, you know, a lot of people pick these up and they go, well, it's Hot Wheels, I'm not. You don't have to use the Hot Wheels stuff. It's still the same good old kit inside. Let's pull out the plastic and see what we're going to have inside the box. We've got our floor pan here. And the bottom side, we can see that it is textured as if it's got carpet on it. And feel all that in there. We've got our steering wheel. This can't be built as a stock vehicle. This is a full custom. We got a more modern steering column and a much more modern steering wheel with shifters. We got some license plate frames there, it looks like. On this tree here, we have something that I always enjoy, is a completely molded frame. Instead of having to build all the individual layers and worry about having three-wheel motion when we're done, we've even got steering on this one, the full steering assembly, and sway bars. So that looks nice on there, and that's a nice looking frame. I like that. We got our engine mounts clear on there and everything, all the cross bracing and supports. Always nice to see that. We've got that much more modern 4.6 liter Cobra V8 from the Mustangs. We got our firewall there, got our dash gauges all set up, and our engine halves, radiator, modern belt and pulley, the serpentine system on there. Look at the big valve covers on there, intake system, oil pan. Even got the front of the motor there, check that out. Nice detail on the molding, on the webbing and all that. Really nicely done. Get a modern engine and a hot rod. These remind me of something that Tim Allen would put together. I just love the old home improvement shows. So I'm going to try to think of a color scheme for mine in that idea. We've got the one-piece hood, radiator surround, which allows us to get that painted up. We've got more frame parts. What else we got? We've got our differential and suspension. Differential cover so you could paint that separately. Exhaust system, if you choose to use the full length exhaust system, will come right off the headers. You can see how it loops up and comes off those. You can see it illustrated on the box here. We've got our straight pipes coming out to an opening, and then you have, if you close that off, it can go out the back of the car, down that little dump there and around the back. Our interior is here. We've got a fuel tank. We've got inner fenders. We've got our seats. And our door panels are separate if you want to do some two-tone door panels in there. Shouldn't be difficult to do. I mean, that molding is really crisp on those door panels. Nice fabric texture to them. And the top actually feels smoother than the door panel. So that's really cool too. This seems like a much more modern kit. We got the giant wheel backs, bigs and littles. We got disc brakes. He upgraded to Wilwoods. Got our front seats, seat back, and various small parts, radiator lines and whatnot on there. Inside of the wheels on the back. And then on the last parts in white styrene are the body itself. Good looking. I like the molded in holes for the taillights. You don't have to try to figure out where the little molding mark was and glue them on. Got a gas cap on this one. Nice trim all the way around the outside. Nice scroll on the front. I like this too. Sometimes if you leave those in because your interior will fit over that, you can grab onto that to paint it. And then we've got an optional top. Removable, you can use it, you don't have to. It has a vinyl texture to it, a nice rough texture with a great seam for trim work all the way around the edges on that as well. Let me go to the other side of the table. We'll pull out our transparent parts. We've got our headlights, we've got the glass for the removable top, and we've got our windshield glass with the nice molding in it. We've got transparent red taillights, which should just push in. What else we got going on? We've got a beautiful set of Goodyear Eagles, bigs and littles, like the wheels. And it is molded on the sidewalls of both sides. So don't worry about missing out on that. The big ones, you can see it a lot better. And check out that tread pattern. And these are somewhat of a stiff vinyl rubber, so sanding these will produce a nice realistic tire texture, which will look nice because they're completely outside the body. So that will look like it's actually been driven. Then we've got a chrome tree, one wheel option, molded open. Got a separate radiator grille. Windshield frame looks nice and it's in one piece. We've got our headers on the side. We've got our front suspension arms. You can see upper and lower there. So you decide if you want to leave them chrome or if you want to paint over them. We've got our light buckets there. We've got shock absorbers in the front out of chrome. I really like those wheels. Very reminiscent of Boyd Coddington wheels. In the Hot Wheels kits, they are providing vinyl press-on decals with gauges and then the exact matching decal sheet in waterslide with the nice flames and the gauges on there, the full gauges, very modern like that. So yeah, definitely cool additions on there for those who want to use the vinyl press-on decals or the water slides. That is your choice. I'm going to start gluing mine together and you can watch me do that right now. we can get a glimpse at all the pieces and parts as things are going to go together. As you see, I've got parts of the chrome tree cut off. And when I was assembling stuff, you saw me put together the headlight buckets. It is a two-piece, and I use that gloss Mod Podge to hold those together because I don't want to have to repaint those. I want those to stay chrome. So I'll let the Mod Podge set now and set overnight instead of doing it tomorrow and kind of being in a rush to do it. We've got our radiator and our serpentine belt system and our electric fan. You'll see there's no, you know, no direct a fan on the engine or anything when we build that up. So these assemblies will get painted and detailed. We've got our shifter and our steering on this tree and our license plate frames if you choose to use the license plates. Got some small engine parts here, coolant lines and other parts to the engine that we can detail and glue on separately. We've got the hood and the radiator surround that I will paint to match the body color I'm using. Speaking of the body, now this may come back to bite me later, but I do have some ideas. For one, I want to get the inner fenders glued in so that they will match the body color. And attaching them to the interior meant I would have had to glue the side panels on, and I want to do the side panels in a two-tone. So I glued them onto the body and they key in beautifully and fit in without any issues. And then I glued on the rear pan as well. Now I should, since I won't be attaching the door panels, I should be able to get the floor pan in, sneak it in there with the firewall and get it all in place and slide my door panels in this direction down into it and lock into the holes at the bottom. The reason the door panels are taped to the floor pan was to kind of mess around with that idea, and I wanted to make sure that I glued the firewall in perfectly straight. That keys into the front of the firewall there, and I wanted to make sure that that was locked in with the model glue, so I just taped those around. This will be detached now, and this is what we will paint up and then slide up into that interior. I will come from the front and get everything in there, and you can see it's going in there pretty good, obviously, aside from this little pin part here. But that will go in, and then I should be able to get my door panels in from that side, and that will allow me to two-tone those door panels. So I've got those all set up, and the door panels will be painted on their own and designed that way. That's just how I choose to do it. On this tree here, we've got our front brakes, we've got our wheel backs, we've got wiring for the engine and a line, a coolant line, or a, I can't really tell what that is, a plumbing line, something for the engine. So these will get painted. With these, when I primer these, then I will detach and then I will spray these in metallic tone so they match my wheels. My steering wheel assembly is all together. That looks pretty sharp. We've got the valve covers on the engine and the intake, which is a three-piece assembly with a cool high-velocity air cleaner on there. So I glued that together, but I don't want it to match the engine. I want these to stand out as separate metallic pieces from the engine, and I want to be able to paint that air cleaner its own color. So that I did not assemble onto the engine. The engine is a little bit of a beauty. The cylinder heads are actually four separate pieces that you saw me put together. Then we've got the front of the engine, we've got filters, we've got starters on there, all kinds of separate pieces to make a very nice looking modern 4.6 liter Cobra engine. And then our intake's just going to go right on top. You can see how it's keyed, large tab, small tab. That will glue on the top, and our valve cover. So that's why I want to do that separately, and I want to paint that engine its own color. We've got our interior pieces, the seats and the seat backs. We've got our exhaust on its own tree to be painted. We've got this frame with what looks like the brake master cylinder and booster attached to it. They hide it underneath. That's going to go on the bottom of the chassis after I attach the exhaust and everything, so I will paint that to match the frame. On the frame, I have an idea of what colors I want to go with on that frame, so I took the differential, I put everything in place as you saw me build it, with the shocks and the springs and the sway bar and the brakes, and those will all drop into place when we're ready to go. And then we've got that as one assembly. The front suspension and the steering, I wanted all to be painted the same color, the same style as the chassis, so I glued it all together. And it does look nice, and it looks like, because those pins are large on the suspension arms, that you could actually attach those much later. There is no steerable steering. Why they included separate spindles in the front that slide them with pins, I don't understand, because the steering rack glues across here and glues into the pins here, so it glues into the frame right here, that nothing's going to steer. Nothing will move. So I'm not sure why that was like that, because it holds it in one position and that's straight ahead at all times. But anyways, that's how it goes. So that's all the parts here. We've got our chrome parts over here. I want to leave those exhaust parts chrome. We've got all the stuff ready to go. We've got our top, our interior. I don't think once the interior's in, you'll ever see that beautiful battery and fuel tank again. But I wanted to assemble it to show you where it goes. And if you open the trunk or whatever, you'll be able to see that, because that's a really nice fuel tank and battery box. Or you could use that for another model somewhere else. So I'm going to get things into paint right now, and I'll see you over there. Time to take a peek at the 32 Ford Phantom Vicky. Now, if you're looking for a kit that's easy to work on, this is it right here. I've done all of this, including the building, the painting, the detailing, all in one day. One day, that's it. So these things, this, if you're looking for a modern rod, a retro rod-ish kind of a vehicle, you know, where you want it more modern, and I forget the exact name for it right now, I forget what they're called, but this is like a Boyd Coddington style ride. We've got the modern style wheels and tires, the 4.6, the electric fan. I've just got things loosely sitting together. This is a sweet, sweet kit, and as you see, so far I haven't used anything from the Hot Wheels. I've used the sticker for the gauges because that works out really well to put them in behind the gauge cluster like that. They just glue into place. I attach the decal to this white backing piece of plastic and then just place them back there, and they look awesome. That's the coolest dashboard I've seen on one of these cars yet. We've got the windshield with its glass glued on. That is going to mount right here. It's got specific grooves when we look at the body. That will mount right there. We can do our top. It will come on and off. Now, I left the top as a flat color, same as the interior. I did not want it done up with a gloss or a vinyl. I wanted it to be flat. It's a show rod, so that's how I wanted it to look. We got our pretty little hood with its metallic purple and all glossed up and all that looking nice. We got the headlights ready to install. Those are all set up with our Mod Podge. We got the steering wheel. I did the steering column in the same purple as the body. Then with chrome on the inside and black around the outside. We've got our radiator braces, which still have to go on. Little pieces of chrome. And we have to attach the body to the chassis. When I get the dashboard in, then I'll put the seats in. Look how nice that turns out when you use that black primer and just a mist coat of the spray paint over the top. You get all that deep detail and luscious looks. We got our little shifter in there. We got our two-tone door panels done. Everything on this kit has just been a joy. I glued the taillights in and I put the purple Hot Wheels license plate on the back, but I didn't use the license plate frame. Taillights in there, under chassis. Got our purple on there all the way around. It is such a sweet looking ride. I really dig this machine. The radiator just drops in. Got our black wash in there. And I metallicized the radiator fan so that it looks more realistic. That's a sharp looking assembly on there. And then finally we got the chassis. Now the rear wheels press on nice and tightly. The front wheels are very, very loose and I'm not gonna put those on until I'm completely done since they sit independent of the vehicle. But you can see what the chassis looks like with just the wheel and tire package on it. Got our 4.6 liter Cobra engine glued in. We'll take those off so they don't fall off. All the way around, we can just take a nice long look at it. Got the headers on, got the exhaust pipe on, got our purple differential back there. Everything else is in a metallic tone. That engine looks sweet in all the different metallic tones that I did it in. And then we've got all like the spark plug wires off the coils. Everything coming off there looks awesome. All the coolant lines and everything. It's just an excellent, excellent model and so far has been very easy to build. The body has these large pins. Those will insert into the chassis. I've already test fit that and it fit in with no issues. Then with a radiator, mounts right into these large grooves in the front. We're talking easy peasy, lemon squeezy. I think the only thing that's going to be difficult would be making sure that the headlights sit upright. They just have little holes on the bottom of the headlight mounts and they go on these little pins in the front. I even put the chrome shocks in. Those just slide in. I remove the pin on the top, insert the pin on the lower suspension arm and just slide them in with tweezers and glue them into place. So we've got the chrome springs on the front. The back, we don't really have any springs that you can see very well. We just have the shocks and everything with our exhaust, and I already painted those a metallic tone around that purple. So far, everything is going extremely well. I don't anticipate any issues. Then I'll decide what water slides I want to use or if I want to modify those for my car or anything, and we will have our final when I come back. AMT's 1932 Ford Custom Vicky Phantom in 1/25th scale in the Hot Wheels theme is all done. You can see I went my own body color. I had this can of metallic purple Tamiya. Had to use it on this car. It is gorgeous. I thought it would look good with the flames, and it does. I did take pictures of the car without the flames on it also at the end of this video. So you can just take a look at what it's going to look like with nothing from the Hot Wheels set on it. You don't have to use those decals. You don't have to use the stickers or the decals, but they are there if you want to use them. I put them on the sides. It does look pretty darn cool with the purple. I wasn't feeling the green on the box art, and that's just a personal selection, but with the purple, I am. The top goes on and off pretty easily. Of course, the turntable's spinning, so I might not line it up perfectly, but yeah, as a RestoMod goes, with like 90s technology, you got that awesome 4.6 liter Cobra motor. This thing must rip, and it's got the big, fat Goodyear Eagles on those custom wheels. I like the wheels. They're big, but they're not gigantic. I really, really dig the look of this kit. The stance, the way it shows itself off, the way that the parts come off and line up, this kit went together so, so nicely. I can't recommend this one enough. Definitely get your orders in. You got that gorgeous engine, so much detail. The headers just push on. The exhaust and the headers connect without even trying hard. The radiator lays in with that cool electric fan detail. This thing, if you're not going to build the kit, is a parts box dream. So much awesome stuff in there. These tires are gorgeous, would look awesome on any other kit. We got the cool windshield, we got the body, we got that interior, which was easy to two-tone. This entire kit was done in a day, folks. One day, from start to finish, everything you saw me filming and everything is working on it at the same time, and then just waiting for stuff to dry. I put it in a food dehydrator at about 100, 110 degrees. Things dry quickly. I was worried about the headlights, but they seem to have gone onto those posts quite easily. I used a thick gel super glue to hold them in place. The suspension goes together easy. The drivetrain, and again, that 4.6, that Cobra motor there with that cold air intake and everything, what a gorgeous motor to stick in tons of other cars, especially if you can see it like that. It is really sharp. Even the radiator support rods just pushed into their holes and lined up where they should allow me to hold it in place and drop a little bit of super glue on each one. The windshield went right in. You can see the windshield pretty much angles itself to hold right onto that top. And you can do it either way. Even when the kit's spinning, I can make it look good. So am I lauding this kit a lot? Yes, this one was just, it was going so fast and so easy that it was easy to do in a day. And I love this look. I think a guy like Tim Allen, who I like his shows quite a bit, I think he would love a rod like this. And if the show would have continued in Home Improvement, they would have modernized it and made it cool and sweet looking with the awesome little taillights and everything. So get this kit on order. I'm going to link in the description where you can snag it. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending it over for review, and we will see all of you at the next review.